In today's video, I'm going to talk about a simple guessing game created using Unity, in which the AI will be trained to follow a sequence of numbers and approximate a function using a TensorFlow.js model so that the player can try to guess the next number in the series given the previous ones. Points will be awarded depending on how near or far that number is from the predicted one by the AI. For the game, we have the following structure. The code for the game, in which we have a couple of prefabs, the current scene, and some mono behavior scripts. The WebGL plugins for communicating from and to JavaScript. The WebGL templates folder, in which we have the Better Unity WebGL template from Gregman and a Node.js project for the TensorFlow code. So let's start. For the Node app, we have a couple of important files. The package.json file, which has some configurations like the app name, version, main script, some other scripts to be called when using different commands, the dependencies which define which libraries we are using, like gulp for watching changes in the contents for the files, TypeScript, so we can compile into JavaScript, and also TensorFlow.js. Then we have the tsconfig.json file, which help us configuring how the TypeScript to JavaScript compilation will work, which types of files to compile, which to exclude, and other configurations we need for the format of the generated JavaScript files. Then we have the gulp file, which uses the tsconfig file and then chains everything together so that every time a .ts file is modified, it triggers the compilation process, replaces some statements that we are not interested in having, and finally it copies those compiled files into the folder in which we are building our Unity game. For the machine learning model, in the index.ts file, I'm going to use TensorFlow.js. TensorFlow.js is a JavaScript library that allows us to train and use machine learning models on the browser and Node.js. I am going to use the simple example model located at the bottom of the main page. In there, they are declaring a pretty simple model that just has one layer, one hidden unit, and also that it will receive just one input. Then the model will be compiled using the mean squared error loss function and stochastic gradient descent. Finally, they declare a couple of arrays of data or tensors, and finally feed or, well, train the model and then predict an output given an input value tensor. So what this code really does is that it will take a couple of numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, the array or tensors for the x-axis, and 1, 3, 5, 7, the tensor for the y-axis, then create a function or, well, a line or equation that tries to approximate and pass near most of the y numbers iteratively using the loss function. So it will look at the current predictive power of the model, let's say an horizontal line, and calculate the distance between the given numbers and that particular line using the loss function. Then what gradient descent will do is minimize this distance by starting to make the aforementioned line or function move little by little as near as possible to most of the points by adjusting some of its parameters, like the slope, for example. Now, on the index .ts file, I am including that same code we saw before, but with some simple modifications. First, I am declaring that I have a public interface object which will expose some functions. The onUnityInitialized function, which is only going to print a message on the console. The startTraining one, which will take the x values and the y values, transform them into tensors and train the model. Once the model is trained, just call a function exposed on the public interface object, notifying that the training is done. And finally, the getPrediction function, which will use the model to make a prediction using the parameters sent. Let's open a terminal or command line, and inside the folder for the NPM project, install all the packages. You also need Node installed for this. Once that's done, we just need to call one of the scripts that we defined on the package.json file. Finally, just make a change inside the index.ts file. There should be a folder inside builds/webgl/js folder with the generated index.js file. Unity allows you to define a template for the code generated with the game. I'm going to use the Better Unity WebGL template from Gregman and make a simple change so that we are including the TensorFlow library and also the generated index.js file from npm. Finally, inside the player settings on the HTML5 tab, I selected the Better template on the WebGL template option. That will make sure to generate that HTML every time I hit build on the build settings. Now, for communicating from JavaScript into Unity, we need a JS lib file with some boilerplate but needed code. Then inside, I declare the initialize.js interface function, which I will be calling from Unity to initialize this part of the public interface object. The same one that I declared on the index.ts file. Then I add the training done function into the public interface object so that it can be used and called from the index.ts file, and send a message to the training done method on the game object called public interface that I have on the scene. Finally, I call the onUnityInitialized function created on the index.ts file from here. The public interface game object has a Unity interface controller mono behavior associated with it, which exposes the training done method so that it can be called by using the send message call. I included here the game controller because I wanted to isolate the code for communicating between JavaScript and Unity. Finally, I call the training done method inside the game controller. To be able to communicate Unity with a JavaScript library like TensorFlow, we also need a JSLib file with the same boilerplate code that we had before, and then the methods that we want to call. In this case, I have the startTraining function that receives the two array pointers and the size for each one. With these, we have to perform a little conversion before we can use them as JavaScript arrays. In the function that we defined in the index.ts file. Finally, I also defined the getPrediction function that, again, only calls another JavaScript function and returns its value into Unity. We also need a class inside Unity so that we can call those two methods. For this, I created the JavaScript interface controller mono behavior and added the declaration for the two methods that I created earlier, the start training and get prediction, and also the initialize.js interface that I exposed on the Unity public interface.js lib file, so that it initializes the JavaScript interface whenever this object starts. Also, this code seems a little bit more complex, but it is because I added a couple of debug methods so that I could test the code inside the editor. Finally, this mono behavior is also attached to the public interface game object. Now, for the game logic, we have a game controller game object on the scene with the game controller mono behavior attached to it that reference some of the UI elements like the player score, the current numbers, and input field for entering the guest number and a button to submit it. Another one for the value predicted by the AI, a reset button, and the network state. Also, I defined a max prediction value that will control the amount of guesses before the game is over. And inside the mono behavior script, aside from the editor properties, we have also the list of numbers in an array format, the current hidden prediction given by the AI, the current score given how near or far the player's guess was from the AI prediction, and the current amount of predictions. Finally, a constant for defining the range for each number in the sequence. We also have the start method, which just resets all the variables in the game by calling the reset method once this game object has started. And the update method that for each frame will check if the player presses the enter key that the game is not over. The guess button is enabled that the input field is not empty before calling the predict method. Then we have the implementation for the reset method, which creates a new list of 5 random values, first from 1 to 5, then from 6 to 10, and so on and so forth. We'll clean the values for the current score and predictions, retrain the network, clear the UI using the new values, and give focus to the input field. The refresh GUI method will take the current values for the numbers lists and score, show them to the player, and disable the guess button and the input field if the game is over. The game over function will return true if the current predictions reaches the max amount of predictions, so as to give a finite amount of guesses to the player. The predict method that will take the number entered by the player, show and add the current prediction given by the AI into the numbers list, calculate the distance between the number and the guess provided by the player, and give a score between 0 and 5. Add 1 to the current predictions variable and then refresh the UI, the input field, and retrain the network. The retrain network method sets the status of the network to training, disables the guess button until the model is trained, and creates the 2 arrays for the model. One with the numbers from 1 until the length of the numbers array, and the other one with the current values of the array, and finally uses the JavaScript interface to trigger the training of the model. The last method, the training done, is used mostly to notify the game that the network finished training, which for this simple model should happen pretty quickly. And then I call again the JavaScript interface to get the next number in the sequence given the trained model. If we open the build settings and click on build using the WebGL platform and select builds / WebGL, as the target folder, and then on select folder. After a few minutes, we should end up with the code necessary to run the game. Let's open the index.html page for our game on the browser and start playing and try to guess a few numbers until the game is over. Awesome! Congratulations and thanks for watching! And if you like the video, please hit subscribe.